Well, it's been 2 weeks since the movie Woodlawn hit the big screen. It's being hailed as a groundbreaking faith film, and it's helping churches to lead young people to Jesus Christ. In this week's Studio 5 segment, Ephraim Graham sits down with the film's star and its producer to talk about why they feel this story was very special right from the start.
Faith meets football in the segregated South of the 1970s.
There's a lot of people out there, Dad.
I know, but they ain't here to see Woodlawn versus Banks. They're here to see you.
It's the real-life premise of the film Woodlawn, which stars newcomer Caleb Castile as Tony Nathan, the Woodlawn football star who endured racism and went on to play for Alabama and the Miami Dolphins.
For me to be able to step into his shoes is just an opportunity that I'll never forget. Mm-hmm.
I have to imagine that this is an answer to prayer for you because you almost didn't play this leading role.
Yeah. That's very true. I was hired as a stunt double, his Tony stunt double, because of my athletic ability and my background there. And then they had some issues with the actor that they had originally hired, just simple work visa, you know, but God had a way, and 3 days before production, they're calling me, telling me that three it might days. Be me, yeah, you know, and so it was just, that in itself was just a learning experience and in a growth period of God increasing my faith and just believing more and more that, you know, he put me here.
The other thing from a physical standpoint, our football coordinator, Mark Ellis, he kept chirping in our ear going, man, I've done so many football films. I've never seen somebody run like this kid. You got to, and I'm like, okay, let's go. I've seen football players. And my jaw dropped. And at the first time, I was like, wow.
Well, I've got to say, I mean, I've covered a lot of films that involve football and faith, and the football in this film is quite more intense, I would say. I mean, even just listening to the sound, looking away. I mean,
yeah, the overall goal was to put the audience in the game. And so John and Andy Irwin, former ESPN camera operators, they know how to shoot football. And they wanted the cameras on the field and really for the audience to feel like you were part of the game. Mm-hmm. And so when we were doing the casting process for Tony, it was important that obviously you want a good actor to do it, but we had to have an athlete. Yeah. And we saw so many actors that would come in, oh yeah, I know football, I play football. And what position? Ah, center field. I'm like, yeah, you're out of here. and you just knew that, you know, good actors, but if they weren't quite what we were looking for from an athletic side, then that wasn't going to work. But God had the right person in mind, mm-hmm. and it just took, and like Caleb said, you know, God was working on both sides to make sure that his plan was divinely executed. And we're not smart enough to be able to do that.
And you'd have no doubt that he did it.
Oh, no doubt. And good with him taking the credit. Like, yeah, totally. Yeah.
I think I can definitely appreciate that because, well, along with the football, because having been a football player for over half my life, you know, and then to transition from that into acting and for God to just say, like, dude, I'm going to set you up a T-ball in your career. Like, you get to play a football player and be the star of this movie. It doesn't, I mean, I could not imagine a better scenario because as being a young black male and in this industry, man, this is a once in a lifetime movie. And I had opportunities before where it just, I'm like, that's not the one, that's not the one, that's not the avenue. And then being faithful and patient and, yeah, but God made it happen, man.
Beautiful. Now, in terms of the football scenes, I was talking to someone, I understand you nearly broke a camera.
Oh, yeah, what that happened day here? With John. Oh, my gosh, yeah. That's hilarious.
An expensive camera, I might add. What happened?
So we were filming, like he said, they wanted to bring the audience into the game. So the way you do that, all football, when you watch on TV, is shot from outside in. So like he said, they put the cameras in the game. You see it. And our director, co-director, John Irwin, who is just out of his mind on set, you know. But I love it. It's beautiful chaos. And so he has a handheld camera, and he's holding a red dragon in his hand. And he's like, no, no, Caleb, I want to chase you. I'm like, okay, okay, so that's cool. So we get in the part of this play, and I make this cut. Somehow John, like, gets in front of me and has, and I'm leaping over him. Then he comes back around. Somebody leaps over him, and he still has this camera holding it up. And I'm like, John, you are insane. But we got the most beautiful shot.
My jaw about draw. I literally went on the field. I said, dude, you can't be doing this. Yeah. And he goes, yeah, okay, let's do it again.
Yeah. Let's do it again.